So we're going to be talking through the guitar two parts for Mighty Cross. This is the Elevation Worship song and the specific arrangement that we're doing for CTI Music Ministries Fulltime Team 17-18. This song is going to be a little bit unique so far in your repertoire. It's the first song that we've trained so far where you're going to have a guitar switch. So you'll start on the acoustic and then kind of halfway through the song, you'll put your acoustic on its stand, pick up your electric, and go from there. So you'll have plenty of time to make that change, but yeah, we'll talk about that in a minute. So far in these videos, we've been kind of separating out the instruction piece from the demonstration, but this song is so simple, I think we're just going to combine them to make things a little bit easier. So we'll talk through the chords first, and then I'll demonstrate it. The guitar chords on the acoustic are very simple. They're ones that you already know. They're just first position, open G chords. So G, C, or you can also do the call them cowboy chords or whatever. C, C, 2, E minor, and D, just like that. And like I said, you can kind of... You can do the, where you just kind of plant your third and fourth fingers on the B and E strings and just keep them there, move your first two fingers. If that's how you learn those chords, you can do that in this song and it works fine until you get to the D. Make sure you take off your fourth finger so it's not a D sus, because that'll clash with the rest of the band. But the other chords should be fine. You'll be adding some nice color notes and you can play them whatever way you're comfortable with. That is really all that you'll be playing on the acoustic chord voicing wise. The thing that you'll want to focus on the acoustic is just being able to like gradually build in the energy a little bit. So when you first come in, the strum is really light in that first turn. Not very busy. And then in the final chorus, or in the bridge, I guess, the bridge is kind of the high point that you'll be playing on the acoustic before you make the switch. That should be very full, so... kind of how you want to build energy there, but the general idea is when the acoustic first comes in, keep it really sparse. You want to, it's this very subtle song. I don't use the word tender, but that word feels weird to me. It's a very, like, it's a part in the song that requires a lot of sensitivity, is what I'm trying to say. So you want to keep things really light. You want to just kind of feel it out, be as sensitive with the part as you can, and then slowly build in energy as you go. Like I said, after the bridge, there's a turn after the bridge, and that is optional for the acoustic. We played this song for summer worship this past summer with CTI, with our summer teams, and I was able to play through the turn and make the switch during the first line of verse 4, which is kind of a full breakdown for most of the band. And that gave me plenty of time to do it, but if your setup isn't ideal, if it takes you just a little bit longer to pull your acoustic off and set it down and pick up your electric and whatever else you need to do, it is okay for you to just duck out on that turn. But either way, after the bridge at some point, you'll ditch the acoustic, pick up your electric, and be ready to go for the build at the very end of verse 4. So like I said, verse 4 is a breakdown, and then when you hear, our hearts will bow, on bow, that's where that D comes in, and you'll start kind of building in there on just power chords. Our hearts will bow before the So that build at the end of verse 4 is just power chords, and I just kind of palm mute and then slowly open up my muting with my right hand so that they grow fuller and have a little bit more energy going into that final chorus. in that final chorus, you'll be doing power chords on the electric, and this is, like I said, the only way that you're going to voice any of these chords in the electric. I'm sure you already know how to do power chords, but just in case, here's D on 5, 7, and 7. And then the G over B in the chorus, I played two different ways just because I think it sounds cool this way. You can either play octave Bs, make sure they're octaves and not the full power chord, not that, that. So you can either play the G over B, an octave B, or you can actually go down and play the power chord G, which is 3, 5, and 5, just like that. I play it differently both times just because I think it sounds cooler. I think the first line, it sounds cooler to go down to the octave B and lead up to the C, and at the end of the chorus, it will never lose its power. I play the G, the full G power chord, because the bass is in the B, so it's that B is already covered. But I go down to the G because I think it lends kind of a deep finality to the end of the chorus. That's just a preference thing. For both of the B over, or the G over Bs, you can play either one that you want. The bass will be in at that point, and they'll be covering the B, so you can choose to play power chord G, or you can choose to play octave Bs if you think it's cooler. Either way is fine. So, we said D, G, or the octave Bs. C is just 3, 5, and 5. And then E minor. I go up to the high E. Sorry, I had to think through the progression in my head. I go up to the high E just because I think it kind of leads up there. Again, it's a preference thing. You can go down to the low. I think it makes things a little bit muddy. I like the high in this particular context, but you can do it either way. So that's up here on 799. Just like that. Cool. So, and you're full, just full power chords through the end of the song at that point. So let me cue up the song and get my acoustic back on, and we'll do just a quick demonstration. So you're out for the intro and for verse one. You'll be in at that first turn after verse one. Also a little note, just for this demonstration, I'm going to be pulling back the volume on my electric just a little bit, or else I can't hear the recording and then I start to get off tempo, which is annoying both for you and for me. So.
On the day that death surrendered to the mighty cross of Jesus Christ, the earth would shake.
And here you want to come in with just really light, really sensitive strumming, just very simple. You'll notice I'll kind of land gently on that D, and then just kind of mute myself. I just think it makes for a nicer arrival in this particular moment.
Resurrection.
guitar solo a little bit there at the end, and a little bit, I think, in the bridge. Like I said, it's just hard for me to hear the recording once I come in. But that should give you a sense of kind of where your parts fall and what you're doing, and a little bit of a sense of how to build energy throughout the arrangement. Just kidding. And yeah, let me know if you have any questions.